We're about to have ourselves a day. A day. It's Double Bass Day, the series where we take two whiskeys and put them head to head to break down the differences and similarities they may have. This week's episode, I'm searching for possibly my favorite bourbon in my whiskey room. The recently reviewed King of Kentucky from Brown-Forman versus Elijah Craig Barrel Proof. This is the old pirate bottle. This is release 11 from 2016, coming in at 139.4 proof. Yeah, let's get nuts. It's Double Bass. What's up, folks? I'm Jason C. from The Mashin' Drum, and welcome to another Double Bass episode. Before we dive into the comparison, let's learn more about what's in each of these bottles. And as always, if you have any comparison suggestions, please leave them down in the comments. First up is King of Kentucky. It's an annual periodic release of a single barrel inventory featuring a barrel strength, minimally filtered proof presentation, with each release and every barrel being described as unique. For this year's iteration, Brown-Forman master distiller Chris Morris chose 33 barrels to set aside for the limited release product. King of Kentucky was actually established in 1881 as a Kentucky straight bourbon. It was later acquired by Brown-Forman in 1936 from selected Kentucky distillers, and by 1940 converted it to a blended whiskey until it was discontinued in 1968. 2018, Brown-Forman revived the label and now pays homage to the brand's past. Mash bill is 79% corn, 11% rye, 10% malted barley. It's 14 years old. My particular bottle is barrel 12, comes in at 132.7 proof, and it retails for about $250. But as we all know, these are highly allocated and usually go for much higher than that. Now, up until now, arguably, my favorite bourbon in my whiskey room, maybe, Elijah Craig Barrel Proof from Heaven Hill, named after the father of bourbon, Reverend Elijah Craig. This bourbon is 12 years old and is bottled at barrel proof without chill filtration. Three batches are put out every year, and this particular one was the second batch for 2016. This is the old style bottle before the design change in 2017. This bottling sits an amazing 139.4 proof. Had a retail price of generally around the same today. You're looking at $65 to $70. So after I reviewed the King of Kentucky, everyone was asking me, hey, is this your favorite, you know, bourbon that you may own? And I mean, I will say it's pretty damn close, but the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof, that old pirate bottle, 139.4 proof, there's something about that bottle that is just so good and rich and oaky and sweet at the same time. It reminded me a little bit of the flavors I got in King of Kentucky, but I figured let's do a crazy head-to-head today. Let's see if that bottle is still maybe my favorite in my whiskey room. Let's see. I mean, I have a lot of great bourbons, but these two, really stand out. So I'll be judging by nose, palate, and finish. Let's see what we get. Number one. Well, the noses on these are going to be ridiculous. I don't know if I'll be able to judge. But this is old. Man, old funky oak. Which you could say about both of them that have that. Just ridiculously rich caramels here. Vanilla extract. This one has some maple syrup going on in it. Some fruits. I think I'm picking a little bit of a cherry up in here. But like an old like cherry cola, like a flat cherry cola. Ugh, this is going to be interesting. All right, let's go to B here. Oh, okay. B has a little bit more of the fruit aspect going on, actually. Bit more vanilla. Man, getting like blackberry, cherry, definitely getting more dark fruits here. God, both of the noses on these are ridiculous. Just rich. And it's all, both of them are just covered in like this rich, super sweet, old oak that's just kind of taking over the whole experience. Man, I don't know which one I like more. The both of these noses I knew going in were going to be pretty stellar. So this one has like a little bit of a funkiness to it that's really, really good, which I really dig. It's got like an old dusty note to it. This one has that, but it's a little bit more on the dark fruit side. You're getting a lot more fruit notes coming out of this. Rich cinnamons here. Man, not really sure which one I like more. I think for nose, I'm gonna lean a little bit towards A, just because it's got that funk in it. But it's not like a bad funk, it's like a dusty bourbon funk. But that doesn't really clue me into which one is which, because even the King of Kentucky, when I reviewed it, had a little bit of like that old funk to it. So I'm gonna give a slight edge to A on the nose. Let's go to the palate. Oh, holy crap. Damn. This is an absolute flavor monster. This is just cinnamon, chocolate, oak, more chocolate, and just like creme brulee just punching you right in the friggin' face. Or punching you in the palate, actually. All right, that one settled my palate. Let's go for another sip here. Oh, man. Butterscotch, ton of vanilla, just that backbone of that old oak, a little bit of the dusty note on it, still, and a finish that just goes on for days. This one has a lot of heat, though, to it as well, though. It's not just, sometimes you try to manage, like, between heat and flavor. This has a little bit of both. You get the flavor, but you get a lot of heat as well. So it drinks definitely a little bit hot. But long, lingering, spicy finish. A lot of cinnamon, black pepper, allspice. A little bit of citrus note, too, on the back end there. Whew. All right, so first glass is a friggin' monster. All right, let's go to the second one, see what we get here. Oh, I'm gonna have to take a second sip of that one, because after coming off this one, oh man, the layers of flavor in number two. This one, I'm getting all those dark fruits and those fruit flavors, but yeah, there's a lot of, again, I'm getting some of the butterscotch in here too. Some of those layers of all the sweet candy notes that you love in a bourbon, but a little bit just thicker and richer. Another sip of two. There's almost like a little bit of a coffee note going on here. Ton of brown sugars. Man, all these dark fruits all intertwined within it. Again, the cherry, blackberry. This one I'm getting a little bit of chocolate, but it's like a dark chocolate. That one's wild. Both of them are really great on the palate. B to me is more nuanced, has some more layers of flavor to it. Another sip here. I'm also getting like a caramel apple in here, which I don't remember getting in either of these beforehand. So that's kind of a new note that's throwing me off a little bit. Man, there's a pepperiness to this. Again, I'm getting some chocolate here too. It's not as, I feel like A comes off more as a freight train. Slight bitterness on A. It might be some of that funky oak finally coming through here. There's a little bit of a bitterness. And then B. And B is just all sweet oak and I'm going to have to give the palate a B on this one. This is what I was afraid of. It's going to like come down to like one friggin' category. Yeah. I like the nose on A. I love the palate on B. B's palate is ridiculous. It is just everything. I mean, butterscotch, chocolate, fruits. It just goes on and on. Now it comes down to finish. And both of them already have stellar finishes. The thing about the finish, though, is like, A, it's lasting longer, but it's also hotter. B, it's lasting long, but I'm not getting as much alcohol as I'm getting flavor. Let's go for one more sip of each and see what we get here. Mmm. Rich, oak, funk, caramel, little butterscotch, ridiculously long, spicy finish, but also alcohol burn, too. So, even though it might be longer than B, I don't know if it's like the flavors I want. Let's see B here. Yeah, I'm gonna have to give the finish to B as well. Just the sheer amount of flavors I'm getting in B, the roundness of it, how it kind of gives you all the spice and all the lingering flavors, the chocolate, the allspice, the cinnamon, little nutmeg too I'm picking up. Now this like caramel apples coming in. Spice, but not like a ton of the alcohol. I think A is where the alcohol's taking over a little bit. But man, A is so freaking good too. These are just any given day, any given Sunday, if this was like a football game, either of these could win. I mean, they're both like right there. So I think overall, I'm gonna have to give it to B. God, what the hell? Okay, let's see what these are. If I had to guess with that old funk, I would guess the A might be the Lagavulin Barrel Proof. But I remember getting a little bit of a dusty funk too on the King of Kentucky. So remember, King of Kentucky is aged with heat cycled warehouses. So sometimes you get a little bit of funk in those barrels. Let's see what we got. So the winner for me is B. I didn't think it would happen. I didn't think that a Logic Crate Barrel Proof would be taken over as my favorite bourbon in my whiskey room, but it has. King of Kentucky comes out as the winner of this double base. Holy crap. So, what can I say? This bottle is just right. Listen, this I could see why people might like maybe Stag or William Lee Weller over this, but when it comes to my flavor profile, this is right where I'm at. And I think this is right where I'm at too. This is right in my wheelhouse too when it comes to a flavor profile. Deep, rich oak, a little bit of funk to it, a lot of really rich flavors. The only thing with this one is that with that 139.4 proof, it drinks like it. And even though this is 132.7, almost 133 proof, I mean, it's not off by much. But yeah, King Kentucky wins out. I am definitely going to be doing this again at some point. Maybe I'll add another bourbon or two in there that also could contend as my favorite. But a few of you out there asked for this matchup. Here it is. King Kentucky wins. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed this double base matchup. We put King of Kentucky versus Elijah Craig Barrel Proof, the old pirate bottle, 139.4 proof. King of Kentucky keeps its crown. So if you guys have any other suggestions for double base episode, please leave them below. I have a couple of scotch suggestions that are coming up soon. So I hope you guys get ready for that. I think you can do Lagavulin 16 versus Laphroaig 16. A couple of other peated matchups too, so that should be fun. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the subscribe button below. Please hit the like button if you haven't yet. Find me on Instagram, find me on Twitter. Let me know what you thought of the matchup. And as I always say, it's not about the whiskey, it's the people you share it with. So cheers. And I bow to the king. Take care, everybody.